Okay, friends, so we have completed the relations sort of part, India and the regional organizations, India and the neighboring countries and so on. Now we shall look into the international organizations, okay? And this part is very important for the prelims point of view. Okay, prelims mein hamesha organizations and reports, ye dono se bahut questions aate IR mein. So let us study that. So biggest news, India has been elected the non-permanent member of UN Security Council. Okay, huge, huge news here. We have been elected as non-permanent member. And India, the only endorsed candidate from Asia-Pacific states, has won 184 out of 192 votes. Okay, and Jan 2021, we are part of it. This is the 8th term as a non-permanent member. And dekha jaye, UN mein, there are 5 permanent members. And the non-permanent members. Okay, non-permanent members may be 10 non-permanent members. They don't have any veto powers. Okay. And this way, if you see, Africa se 2 countries aana chahiye, Asia se 3, Latin America, Caribbean se 2, Western Europe se 2, and Eastern Europe se 1. Okay, Arab and Turkey ka alag hi, matlab Asia and Latin America se, Asia and Africa se chalta hai. So along with India, so many other countries have been elected, and India has pledged to guide it by 5 priorities and the norms. Okay, this is important. New orientation for reformed multilateral system. Okay, hame India international organization mein ek baat hamesha yaad rakhna hai, multilateralism. We are a huge forerunner of multilateralism, and this we want to achieve by 5S approach. Okay, samman, samvad, sahyog, Shanti Samriddhi. Okay, this actually was given by our External Affairs Minister S. Jayashankar ji. He had given this. Okay, 5S approach. So each year, General Assembly elects 5 non-permanent members for 2-year term, and retiring member is not eligible for immediate re-election. Okay, internal bhi aapko bata diya. And isme non-permanent bodies mein, India is chairing the committees on terrorism. Okay, India's leading voice for terrorism. 3 important committees. Counter-Terrorism Committee, CTC. After 9-11 attack, ke baad ye rakhe the. Next, Taliban Sanctions Committee. So this will become interesting actually. Now with the Taliban movement in Afghanistan, India is heading this. India is chairing them. Okay, heading this committees. Okay, it's 1988 Sanctions Committee. It designates individuals and entities for participating in financing, planning, facilitating or perpetrating all these arms and entities associated with Taliban. Okay, the listed entities are subject to assets freeze, travel ban and arms embargo. And lastly, Libya Sanctions Committee. So all member states are required to prevent sale of arms and other material to Libya, prevent entry into or transit through all territories, freeze oil funds and all so on. Okay? So, a counter-terrorism, then Taliban, then Libya. Okay, 3 committees ka India is chairing. And other committees bhi hai, like UNSC Committee 1267, which was for limited air embargo and freezing for the Taliban. Okay? Next, we have non-aligned movement. Non-aligned movement is in news because online summit of NAM contact group has declared solidarity on COVID-19. Okay, PM himself has participated. Generally, NAM ka jo summits and all jo hote, PM doesn't participate. Okay, Vice President ko bhej dete hum, but now PM has participated. United against COVID-19, international solidarity. Ye hua Republic of Azerbaijan. Okay, Azerbaijan, currently chairman of NAM group. Okay, NAM may all this, and NAM, you should remember, it is the second largest grouping after UN, United Nations. That's a huge grouping. Okay, Central Asia, India, entire Africa, almost entire Africa, and this Colombia, Peru, Chile, all of them, they're part of it. So it's formed during Cold War as organization of states which did not formally align themselves with US or Soviet Union, but they wanted to remain independent or neutral. So Asia-Africa Conference was held in Bandung, Vietnam's first conference, Belgrade Conference, was held in 1961 under India, Yugoslavia, Ghana and Indonesia, Belgrade. So 1955 mein Bandung Conference bahut famous hai. In 1961 mein Belgrade for conference bhi famous. It's a NAM's first conference. And Asia Africa Conference bhi NAM jaise sochte hain. So it's on five principles of Panchsheel, which is our RAI EP, which is mutual respect for each other's territorial integrity, sovereignty, then non-aggression, non-interference, equality, mutual benefit, peaceful coexistence. Okay, all these are five principles of Panchsheel, and it has 120 members, all of them from Africa. There are also some observers. Okay, next we have BIMSTEC. So BIMSTEC Secretariat has finalized BIMSTEC Charter after 23 years of its inception. So this charter is to sign 5th summit, and it's for long-term vision, delineating roles and responsibilities. And abhi tak wo Bangkok Declaration nahi chal raha tha, BIMSTEC Charter nahi tha, which was not comprehensive and geopolitical scenario alag hai. So now BIMSTEC Charter has come. BIMSTEC mein kaun kaun hai? BIMSTEC mein we have our Bangladesh, India, Myanmar, Sri Lanka, Thailand. Okay, this is BIMS plus Bhutan and Nepal. Okay, that is our BIMSTEC. So BIMSTEC, as I was telling you, it was established as BISTEC, and later Myanmar, Nepal and Bhutan had joined it. ठीक है, फर्स्ट समिट मीटिंग वॉज हेल्ड इन बैंकॉक, दैट्स वे द बैंकॉक डिक्लेरेशन चल रहा था इसका, एंड सेक्रेटेरिएट इज इन ढाका. ओके, BIMSTEC इज होम टू अराउंड 1.5 बिलियन पीपल, विच मेक्स अप 22% ऑफ वर्ल्ड्स पॉपुलेशन. इट हैज जीडीपी ऑफ 2.8 ट्रिलियन डॉलर्स. ठीक है, ये भी पंचशील टाइप प्रिंसिपल से. देर आर 14 प्रायोरिटी एरियाज. इंडिया इज अ लीड कंट्री फॉर ट्रांसपोर्ट, टूरिज्म, environment, counter-terrorism and etc. Okay, next, 2020 BRICS summit was held, chairmanship of Russia, BRICS for global stability, shared security, innovative growth. So this started in 2001 as BRIC, which was an acronym by Goldman Sachs, and later South Africa was added in 2010. Okay, the notion is they would become the global growth by 2050. सब पीस, सिक्योरिटी, डेवलपमेंट, ह्यूमैनिटी, इक्विटेबल फेयर वर्ल्ड, ये सब है. एंड इसमें मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट ब्रिक्स में क्या क्या है, दे हैव द न्यू डेवलपमेंट बैंक, द सिक्स ब्रिक्स समिट इन ब्राज़ील ऑन द लाइन्स ऑफ एशिया डेवलपमेंट बैंक एंड वर्ल्ड बैंक. एंड इसमें सबसे बड़ा शेयर होल्डर क्या है, ऑब्वियसली चाइना. एंड इट हैज़ $10 बिलियन टू कॉम्बैट द पैंडमिक, ब्रिक्स बैंक ने रखा है. एंड पोर्टफोलियो इन्वेस्टमेंट्स इज मोर देन $20 बिलियन. There are many large projects, and it's also accepting new members like Uruguay, UAE and Philippines. So BRICS mein 4 hai, 5 hai, but new development bank mein aur bhi countries hai. Okay, India was the main BRICS country behind NDP and remained the largest beneficiary of NDP loans. Okay, next, they had set up a contingency reserve arrangement for mutual financial support, something like IMF, and contribution to global financial net. And also they have set up BRICS Research Development Center. Okay, not so important all this. Ek STI framework bhi rakhi 2015 mein. Trade has grown by 45%. In other areas, there's a payment task force and rapid information security channel for cyber threats. So first meeting of BRICS contact group on economic and trade issues was held under India's chairmanship. BRICS had 15 years rakhe the. Why is this 15 years? Because we have seen it was set up in 2006. Okay, foreign meters, ministers meet in NYC. Matlab first official summit was in Russia in 2009. But generally it's taken up from 2006. Again, after this first foreign ministers summit. Okay, So BRICS-ED 15, next it presented calendar of events BRICS CG80 for MSME roundtable. The all choti choti cheeze hai, not very important. Non-tariff measures, sanitary, phytosanitary measures, genetic resources, traditional knowledge, in sab ke choti choti ki. The next 17th ASEAN India summit was held virtually. India contributed $1 million for COVID ASEAN response fund. Both India and ASEAN, they welcomed the adoption. New plan of action builds upon the achievements made under previous plan of action. It guides ASEAN-India strategic partnership. It elucidates future strategies and possible arrangements. So ASEAN mein kaun kaun hai? ASEAN mein we have the CMLV countries. Okay, which is your Cambodia, Myanmar, Laos and Thailand. Cambodia, Myanmar, Laos and Thailand. Okay, these four countries are there. They are the CMLV countries. And, CMLVT, Vietnam. Cambodia, Myanmar, Laos, Vietnam, Thailand. Okay, CMLVT countries, Yapura iska. And Malaysia, Singapore, next Indonesia, for Brunei Darussalam, Malaysia, I hope you know, this Borneo Island, jo hai, iske upar Malaysia bhi hai, so Malaysia, Brunei hai, and Indonesia bhi, and Philippines, okay, all of this are there. And ASEAN ko hamesha yaad rakhne ke liye, please remember the CMLVT and geographically try to remember. Okay, ek ye landmass jo hai, this is CMLVT. Phir ye landmass mein we have Malaysia, Indonesia, your Singapore and Brunei. Theek hai, ye char ho gaye. फिर लास्ट है फिलीपींस. फिलीपींस थोड़ा दूर है. ठीक है, सो देर आर 10 कंट्रीज एज पार्ट ऑफ द आसियन मेंबर कंट्रीज. फिर से बोल रहा हूँ, ध्यान रखिए, वी हैव CMLVT, 5 कंट्रीज लैंडमास. ज्योग्राफिकली याद रखिए, ये लैंडमास में 5 कंट्रीज है, प्लस मलेशिया, सिंगापुर, इंडोनेशिया, ब्रूनेई दारुसलम एंड फिलीपींस. Okay, these are the other 5 countries. Phir India reiterated $1 billion. See, hame international bodies mein actually more than the current affairs, uska background important. Okay, ASEAN ke bare mein dekha jaye, it's intergovernmental of 10 Southeast Asian countries. Economic, political, security, India became strategic partner. And Act East policy mein important hai, hai na? And India has a free trade agreement with ASEAN. India became the third dialogue partner of ASEAN to initiate ASEAN Connectivity Coordinating Committee meeting. Next, RCEP. So recently 15 Asia Pacific nations have signed RCEP while India choosing to opt out. So RCEP bahut easy hai yaad rakhne ke liye. Ye hamara 10 countries jo hai wo hai, and uske saath hai SCANJE, SCANJE. पहले इंडिया भी हुआ करता था, बट नाउ अभी 15 है SCANJE. ठीक है, तो CMLVT, MSIBP, फिर SCANJE. ठीक है, RCEP में ये सारे हैं, CMLVT प्लस MISB plus SCANJE, so that you'll never forget. Last year I think ye puche the 2020 mein RCEP mein kya kya countries. Okay, Prime Minister ISB, you can remember. Philippines thoda alag hai, side mein hai. Ye sare ek mein hai. Malaysia, Indonesia, Singapore, Brunei. Theek hai, they have signed this. And what is actually RCEP? RCEP is the free trade agreement between ASEAN and the other countries. It now presently it's the world's largest trade bloc, please remember, more than WTO. Okay, covering 2.2, not in terms of economic trade, in terms of the people, $2.2 billion people and 30% world economy. So it was proposed in ASEAN meet in 2011, tab se chal rahe the baat, and while India was part of RCEP, it was dropped in 2019 due to some dairy issues and China issues and all. But later, in fact, India is given the option that later we can join. Okay, next, UN Human Rights Council. Why is it in news? Because Pakistan has been re-elected to it. Pakistan ek human rights hai nahi unke, but they have been re-elected to Human Rights Council. So UNHRC was established in 2006 by UNGA resolution, and it is the principal intergovernmental body with the UN system responsible for strengthening, promoting the human rights around the globe. So it replaced the former UNHCR. Okay, UNCHR ko it has replaced UNHRC. So it's 47 members who are elected by simple majority through secret ballot. They have 3-year term with 1/3 members being renewed each year. Okay. Human rights kya hai? They are the ones which are there just because we exist. Okay, they are not granted by a state, they are universal to all of us. Most fundamental, the right to life, which make life worth living, like right to food, education, work, health, liberty. UNDHR adopted 1948 was the first legal document, and it along with two covenants, International Covenant for Civil Political Rights, International Covenant for Economic, Social, Cultural Rights, make up the International Bill of Rights. Okay, UDHR plus Civil Political Rights, that's Economic, Social, Cultural Rights. Okay, yes, sare are the International Bill of Rights. Universal hona chahiye, non-discriminatory, inalienable, interdependent human rights. So it's based on equitable geographical distribution with so-and-so African states and all UN members are eligible to run a seat on the council. 170 members have already signed this, and it holds 3 sessions per year and total of at least 10 weeks, and they can call special sessions also. Suggestions, resolutions and all, they are not legally binding. That's why it's not very important. That's why India bhi jaake UN Human Rights Council pe halla karta hai, Pakistan bhi jaake karta hai and all, but kuch hota nahi, because it's not legally binding. But as a subsidiary body, it reports to assembly. It receives substantive and technical support from UN Office on High Commissioner for Human Rights, okay, within the UN Secretariat. But in 2018, US had pulled out of UNHRC, calling it cesspool of political bias and mockery of human rights. Okay, because of Israel-Palestine issue, UN had pulled out because of Donald Trump, and that's why 2018 mains mein bhi yehi puche the, Human Rights Council pe. So ye Office of High Commissioner on Human Rights, ye kya cheez hai? It's a department of UN Secretariat for promoting and protecting full realization by all people, Charter of UN and international human rights. So preventing human rights violation, respect for human rights, ye sare karne ke liye it hai. Okay, please remember, it is there as part of UN Secretariat. It prelims mein aayega, ye important. Next, International Criminal Court. Recently, US President has authorized economic sanctions against ICC for their investigation into war crimes by US forces and CIA since 2003. So ICC hai kya? ICC is a permanent international court to investigate, prosecute and try individuals for committing crimes of genocide, crimes against humanity, war crimes and crimes of aggression. Okay, in sab ke liye, it's there, and iske features thode important hote. Okay, please remember, it is not for personal capacity. Personal capacity mein agar kuch kiya hai wo, koi ruler, tab nahi aayega. Okay, it's international court to investigate, persecute individuals for serious crimes which affect the international community. Okay, अगर वो genocide किया, crime against humanity किया, war crimes किया, aggression किया, okay, individuals को भी, okay, it can try. So it is by Rome Statute of International Criminal Court. Court has jurisdiction over crimes after 2002. 123 countries are party. Countries have never signed like India, China, Iraq, North Korea, Saudi Arabia, Turkey. Okay, because of the Rome Statute. Why? Because hame Supreme Court is a sovereign court. Okay, really sorry friends. I hope your eardrums are still fine. Extremely sorry. India is not part of Rome Statute क्योंकि हमें Supreme Court is a sovereign court, right? But ये Rome Statute में है कि it's like above the Supreme Court, so that's why India has never signed. And some have signed and not ratified, like US. Some have withdrew also, Burundi, Philippines and all. And it does not replace the national criminal justice system, but it complements them. So member country can refer it, UN Security Council can refer it. Prosecutor can launch an investigation on own initiative. Okay, suo motu. So in that way we have. And if you compare ICJ and ICC, ICJ is part of our UN bodies. Okay, UN official court of UN. It's called as World Court. It's a peace palace in The Hague. ये भी वैसे हेग नहीं है. And this is the difference. ICJ is against the government, okay, but this is the individual, okay, contentious between parties, advisory opinions. This is criminal prosecution of individuals. Sovereignty, border, boundary disputes, maritime disputes in some name, this is the genocide crime, crime against humanity and all. And states which ratify UN charter under article 93, they'll come under ICJ. Non-UN members can also become parties to ICJ by ratifying ICJ statute, and each state must provide consent to any contentious case by agreement, declaration or treaty clause. ठीक है? So UN charter, if you are signing, you'll come under it. Obviously you'll come under states which ratify under article 93, they'll come under ICJ. But if you are a non-UN member also, then also you can come under ICJ by ratifying ICJ ka dusra statute. Okay, they must provide consent for contentious, consent to any contentious case by explicit agreement. And ICJ ke upar koi appeal hai? Nahin, there is no appeal. In a contentious case, it's binding upon parties. If state fails to comply with the judgment, then it can be taken up to UN Security Council, which can review, recommend and decide upon reinforcement. ICC में है अपील है. ओके, आर्टिकल 80, इट अलाउज फॉर रिटेंशन ऑफ एक्विटेड डिफेंडेंट पेंडिंग अपील. ठीक है, सो ये यूएन का कोई बॉडी नहीं है, इट्स कंप्लीटली इंडिपेंडेंट, राइट? इट मे रिसीव केस रेफरल्स फ्रॉम यूएन सिक्योरिटी काउंसिल एंड विदाउट यूएन एक्शन और रेफरल आल्सो इट कैन वर्क. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट UNCLOS. Recently, Permanent Court of Arbitration have given ruling in Enrica Lexi case, the Italian Marines case, for killing of two Kerala fishermen. So what did they give? The Enrica Lexi case is an ongoing international controversy about shooting of two Indian fishermen. And in 2015, Italy had filed a case against India for detaining two Marines in ITLOS, Tribunal on Law of Sea, under UN Convention of Law of Sea. Later it went to the Permanent Court of Arbitration. ये तीसरा type of court, ये भी हेग में है. Okay, हेग में ही सारे कुछ है, ये तीसरा type of court है. Okay, ICJ, ICC से अलग है. So, UN clause क्या है? पहले, PCA बोल रहा था ना, what is PCA? PCA was under Convention of Pacific Settlement of International Disputes. ये सबसे पुराना है. 1899 में, ओके, पैसिफिक सेटलमेंट ऑफ इंटरनेशनल डिस्प्यूट्स में, इट्स एन इंटर गवर्नमेंटल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन प्रोवाइडिंग वैरायटी ऑफ डिस्प्यूट रेजोल्यूशन सर्विसेज फॉर स्टेट एंटिटीज, इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस, प्राइवेट पार्टीज भी है. So it has three part administrative structure, like administrative council hota hai, independent potential arbitrators and secretariat. Called as international bureau, ye bhi Hague mein India as its member. Theek hai? So yahan pe agar aapko dekha jaye to there is another PCA. Ye 1899 mein hai. ये यूएन से कुछ लेना देना नहीं, ये भी इंडिपेंडेंट है, ये हेग में है. इसका सारे आते हैं, स्टेट आते हैं, प्राइवेट आते हैं, ऑल ऑफ देम विल कम, ऑल ऑफ देम देयर इज अ मिक्सचर, एंड दिस इज लाइक एन आर्बिट्रेशन कोर्ट, ओके, फॉर डिस्प्यूट रेजोल्यूशन सर्विसेज. ठीक है, इंडिया इज पार्ट ऑफ इट. PCA and sare Hague mein, please remember. So UNCLOS is an international agreement which resulted from 3rd UN Conference on Law of Sea. So it was adopted in 1982 and it is called as Law of Sea Convention or Law of Sea Treaty. So it defines rights and responsibilities of nations with respect to their use in world's oceans, guidelines for business, environment, marine natural resources and so on. So currently 167 countries have joined it, India has ratified it, and ye UNCLOS mein there are three new institutions. What are they? First is ITLOS, ye tribunal nahi abhi ruling diya tha. It is an independent judicial body established by UNCLOS for adjudicating disputes. Okay, disputes relating to living resource of sea, protection, preservation of marine concern, navigation, ये सब में है. 21 members है. It is open to state parties for convention other than state parties like state enterprises and private entities. Similarly, we have the ISA in Jamaica. ये क्या है? It is for organizing, regulating and control of mineral related activities. Okay, seabed areas, national jurisdiction, ESAP, and all parties of UNCLOS, they are members of the ISA. Last is CLCS, Commission on Limits of Continental Shelf. It is assigned to play mainly two significant roles for establishing outer limits on continental shelf beyond 200 nautical miles, like to evaluate claim of coastal state for area of continental shelf beyond 200 nautical miles, provides scientific and technical advice for coastal state. It has 21 members. So in dono ke 21 members. But you have 21 members, independent members hai, 21 members hai, geology, geophysics, state parties ke elected wale hai. Theek hai? So UNCLOS ka sabse bada most important yahi hai, of how it divides the marine areas. Okay. So, sabse pehle, there is the baseline, low water line called as baseline. Okay. And baseline se pehle jo bhi hai, it is the internal waters. Okay. They are the waters on the landward side of baseline from the breadth of the territorial sea is measured. So, each coastal state had full sovereignty of internal waters, like its land territory, like bays, ports, inlets, rivers and lakes, they are connected to sea. Next, they have territorial sea. Territorial sea is the 12 nautical miles. Okay, coastal states, they have sovereignty and jurisdiction over this. And not only surface, but also seabed, subsoil and even airspace. Okay, so yaha tak sare state ka hai. Okay, internal waters, territorial sea. Aur thoda aage diye hain 12 nautical miles tak. What is 12 nautical miles? It's a contiguous zone. Contiguous zone mein kya hai? It extends 12 from territorial sea, and coastal state has right to prevent and punish infringement of fiscal, immigration, sanitary and custom laws. Okay? And unlike territorial sea, it gives jurisdiction to state on ocean surface and floor. ठीक है, कंटिग्यूअस स्टेट में, कंटिग्यूअस जोन में एयर स्पेस राइट्स नहीं है, प्लीज रिमेंबर. ओके, इंटरनेशनल एयर स्पेस यहाँ से शुरू हो जाता है. टेरिटोरियल में एयर भी आता है, कंटिग्यूअस में एयर नहीं आता है, ओनली ओशन सरफेस एंड फ्लोर आता है. ठीक है. नेक्स्ट है एक्सक्लूसिव इकोनॉमिक जोन, दिस इज 200 नॉटिकल माइल्स फ्रॉम द बेस लाइन. अ कोस्टल स्टेट हैज सॉवरन राइट्स फॉर एक्सप्लोरिंग एक्सप्लॉइटिंग कंजर्विंग मैनेजिंग नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज विदन लिविंग और नॉन लिविंग ऑफ सी बेड एंड सब सॉइल. And rights to carry out activities like production of energy from water, and it only allows above mentioned resource rights. It does not give the state to prohibit or limit freedom for navigation or overflight. There are some exceptions ki agar wo navigation kar raha hai sea pe, there should be innocent passage. Matlab agar underwater submarine ja raha hai, wo usko surface pe aana 200 nautical miles. 200 नॉटिकल माइल्स के ऊपर जो है इट इज द हाई सी, मतलब उसके बाहर इट इज द हाई सी. ओके, तो यहां तक कम्स अंडर योर कंट्री डायरेक्टली और इनडायरेक्टली. देयर आर सो मेनी थिंग्स. अभी ये कॉन्टिनेंटल शेल्फ क्या चीज है, पहले वो हाई सीज क्या है. हाई सीज आर द ओशन सरफेस एंड वाटर कॉलम बियॉन्ड द ईईजेड. ठीक है, इट इज बियॉन्ड नेशनल ज्यूरिसडिक्शन. But state can undertake peaceful purposes, transit, marine science, undersea exploration, all we kar sakte hai. So now ye continental shelf kya cheez hai? Continental shelf is the one which we study in geography. Theek hai? Jahan tak wo kya bolte hai? Hamara sloping hota hai land, right? The underwater jo sloping hota hai, that is your continental shelf. Theek hai? Wahan se seedha girta hai. ठीक है, सो दैट इज कॉन्टिनेंटल शेल्फ. एंड प्लीज रिमेंबर, कॉन्टिनेंटल शेल्फ कैन बी बियॉन्ड 200 नॉटिकल माइल्स आल्सो. सो दैट टाइम द क्लेम ऑफ कोस्टल स्टेट फॉर एरिया ऑफ कॉन्टिनेंटल शेल्फ बियॉन्ड नॉटिकल माइल्स जो है दैट इज अंडरटेकन बाय द CLCS. इंडिया इज पार्ट ऑफ दिस आल्सो. इट प्रोवाइड साइंटिफिक टेक्निकल एडवाइस फॉर सबमिशन ऑफ द क्लेम. फाइन, सो इन दिस वे वी हैव द three institutions under UNCLOS. Fine friends, UNCLOS 1982 mein sign hua hai. It's called Law of Sea Convention and all. And isme dispute resolutions kya hai? ITLOS hai, jo judicial body, jo hamara marines case mein aaya hai. Okay. ITLOS mein sabse pehle aaya tha. It was later referred to the PCA. ठीक है, ITLOS है, ICJ है and Special Arbitral Tribunal है. एंड ये केस जो है ये ITLOS से ही गया है, कहाँ PCA गया है. ओके, दिस वे वी हैव वेरी टेक्निकल, अ बिट टफ बट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. प्लीज रिमेंबर, बस आप लिमिट्स याद रखिए. पहले बेस लाइन है, बेस लाइन से 12 नॉटिकल माइल्स इज माई टेरिटोरियल. वहां से अनदर 12 नॉटिकल माइल्स इज माय कॉन्टिग्यूस. ओके, दिस इज टेरिटोरियल, दिस इज कॉन्टिग्यूस एंड 200 नॉटिकल माइल्स. 200 नॉटिकल माइल्स, प्लीज डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज, इट इज फ्रॉम योर बेस लाइन. ठीक है, बेस लाइन से. या अगर आपको ये कंफ्यूजन हो रहा है, ये जस्ट रिमेंबर 12, 24, 200 सारे बेस लाइन से है. ठीक है, बट कंटिग्यूस जोन थोड़ा ये है क्योंकि ये बीच में आता है. सो दैट्स व्हाई आई सजेस्ट स्टूडेंट्स टू रिमेंबर दिस वन. लाइक व्हाट आई एम टेलिंग इज पीपल ऑल्सो रिमेंबर इट लाइक 12 टेरिटोरियल, मतलब बेस लाइन से, सो दैट नो कंफ्यूजन होना चाहिए. फिर 24 कंटिग्यूस जोन, फिर 200 इज योर एक्सक्लूसिव इकोनॉमिक जोन, सारे बेस लाइन से. ठीक है, बट कंटिग्यूस में थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम है क्योंकि कंटिग्यूस इज नॉट 0 टू 24, इट इज 12 टू 24. ठीक है, दिस इज 0 टू 12, दिस इज ऑल्सो 0 टू 200, बट दिस इज 12 टू 24. बट ये भी याद कर सकते हो 12, 24, 200, क्योंकि आपको बेस लाइन का कोई कंफ्यूजन नहीं होगा. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट वी हैव वर्ल्ड हेल्थ असेंबली. रिसेंटली 73rd वर्ल्ड हेल्थ असेंबली वाज डन. व्हाट इज WHO? इट इज द डिसीजन मेकिंग बॉडी ऑफ वर्ल्ड हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. So all delegates have attended it for determining policies of WHO, appointing Director General Financial Policies. It is held in Geneva. So they have come up the resolution for impartial, independent, comprehensive evaluation for zoonotic source of the coronavirus. And they have told of One Health. What is One Health? It is a collaborative, multi-sectoral, transdisciplinary approach with the goal of achieving optimal health outcomes, recognizing interconnection between people, animals, plants, and shared environment. So it mentions actions of WHO pertaining to COVID-19. It calls for universal, timely, equitable access. It calls for removal of unjustified obstacles in TRIPS and flexibility within the Doha Declaration of TRIPS. Okay, matlab there are some obstacles in the TRIPS and Doha Declaration, so usko hatane ko bola. And related news, we have the WHO Executive Board. Indian Health Minister took charge as chairman of WHO Executive Board. Okay. And it's composed of 34 technically qualified members. Primary function of board is implement definitions of WHO. Chairman is held, is changed by rotation. And related, what is this Doha Declaration? It is adopted in 2001 by WTO for ambiguities of public health and TRIPS. And it affirms that TRIPS does not and should not prevent members from